Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video where I am going to discuss very interesting concepts in a very comprehensive as well as concise manner. So let's begin with this video. Guys, before beginning with the question, I have 2 to 3 informations to dispatch. So first of all, this is the dive schedule, the schedule of our live classes we have launched for SEBI, RBI and ABAT. You can see the timetable, and guys, live session gives us an opportunity to connect with you guys. At the same time, you also have an opportunity to ask your doubts directly then and there itself. If you have anything that you are not understanding while watching the video, while at the time when the teacher is teaching you, you have this opportunity now to ask the teacher again to elaborate on that topic. So that is the benefit. You can check the courses on our application as well as on our website. Okay guys, now before moving on to the questions, the second information is that this is, guys, our mobile number. You can call us 9 to 6 Monday to Saturday if you want any kind of guidance, okay? And if there is anything that you are struggling with in our course or in your preparation generally, then also we are here to resolve your queries. You can also directly connect with the mentors at discussions.anujindal.in, okay? discussion.anujindal.in. So this is the website, okay, where you can post your queries and we directly resolve them. And we also have this mail, email ID. You can mail us if you have any queries. So that was the, that were the ways in which you can connect with us. One more and the last information for you all is that the PDF of this session is already there on the Telegram channel. So take a pause, download the PDF, keep the PDF beside you, and then listen what I'm telling you. Okay, so now let's begin with the questions. I hope that you have downloaded the PDF by now and the PDF is beside you. So the very first question that we have, a bit lengthier question, but we know that RBI has an inclination towards long question. So let's begin. Recently, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has approved the Bharat New Car Assessment Program, India's own vehicle safety assessment agency, to start functioning from April 1st, 2023. This system is equivalent to the star ratings for Indian cars based on crash test. It will allocate star ratings from 1st to 5 stars. It is in line with the government's aim of reducing road accidents by 10% by 2024. So guys, this is the target of the government. So what is the target? The target is to reduce it by 50% by 2024 and to make it 0%, to reduce the road accidents to 0% by 2030. So these two are the targets. Do remember, and the government is working ambitiously on this to reduce the road accidents. And you should be knowing this fact that India is the country which has the highest burden of road accidents and fatalities caused by the road accidents. So it is pertinent for us to reduce that number. Okay, so now what is the function of this Bharat New Car Assessment Program? As stated in the question itself, and as you can clearly see in front of you, it is going to test the cars before they are launched into the market. Crash test hoga gaadi ka ki kitni protective hai ye, how much safe is the car is for the passengers. So that is the basic function of this vehicle safety assessment agency of India. Now one more thing is, so this is, guys, about the eligibility of the vehicles to be tested by Bharat NCAP. Okay, so as you can see that it has a lot of, you can say, facts here, numbers are there. You don't need to remember these numbers because nobody is going to ask you such numbers. Okay, so let me just read it out for you that which kind of vehicles would be tested by Bharat NCAP. So there would be category M1 vehicles, okay, which are the motor vehicles used for the carriage of passengers comprising 8 seats in addition to the driver's seat. So the vehicles which have 8 seats plus a driver's seat, those vehicles would be tested by the Bharat NCAP. And now this you can remember, because this is the basic eligibility and the basic fact about a government's initiative which can be asked in the examination. Further, we have another category of vehicles whose gross weight should be less than 3.5 tons. Either they are manufactured or imported in the country. So the vehicles which have the weight less than 3.5 tons would also be tested for their safety by the Bharat NCAP. So these two are the eligibility criteria. Please remember these facts, because these can be asked. Moving ahead, so guys, this system is going to give 1 to 5 stars to the safety features of the cars, okay? And on the basis of the stars given to the cars, obviously customers are going to get benefit. They are going to buy the cars which has maximum stars, and this will basically inculcate a sense of competition and a sense of, you can say, responsibility among the manufacturers themselves. They will create the vehicles which are more safer, which are safer for the consumers, okay? So this is going to imbibe a healthy competition in the market. Then we have the government's aim to reduce the road accidents by 50%. Now guys, in order to reduce road accidents, one more key initiative has been taken by the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, which is in front of you. So guys, this is the integrated road accident database. Now, I have taught you this initiative many times, therefore I'm not going to teach you again this, okay? But I have one question for you from this. So my question is that with which IIT has the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways collaborated for creating this system? This is your question, guys. Do tell me in the comment section below. And I hope that by now, after giving your phase 1 and phase 2, you must have known by now that RBI does not only stick to what is there in the current affairs. It can ask you the very key initiatives of the government that were there in the news 1 or 2 years back. And this is one such initiative. So please tell me the answer and prepare this initiative thoroughly. Moving ahead, the next question is, where was the National Conference on Development of Space Startup Ecosystem in India organized? So guys, it was organized in Bangalore, okay? So here ISRO is also situated. So there only the National Conference on Development of Space Startup Ecosystem. So here now the ISRO is focusing on developing the space startups in the field of space, okay? So in India, so that many more startups can be brought on the ground, okay? So we have Pixel, we have Garuda Aerospace, halaki ye to drone wali hai, but still Garuda Aerospace is there. Then we have Skyroot Aerospace. These are some of the most prominent startups or private companies working in the space sector, but we need to have more and more startups in the space sector. Therefore, we have organized this conference wherein we have gathered the ideas to boost this ecosystem. I hope that you have understood it by now. Now, do remember that this entire name of this conference is also abbreviated as DESI. Okay, DESI, basically DESI. ठीक है, देशी या देसी कह लो, वट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू से. वन मोर फैक्ट फ्रॉम हियर इज दैट दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज एट हिल्टन कन्वेंशन सेंटर इन बैंगलोर. ओके, दिस मच इज इनफ. नाउ हु ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इट? सो इसरो, एस्ट्रोनॉटिकल सोसाइटी ऑफ इंडिया, DRDO, इंडियन नेशनल स्पेस प्रमोशन एंड ऑथराइजेशन सेंटर. माई क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम यू ऑल इज, यू हैव टू टेल मी द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ एस्ट्रोनॉटिकल Society of India and Indian National Space Promotion and Authorization Center. These two headquarters are your question. And guys, this is the picture that I found for the national conference. So you can see the picture so that it can help you memorize it better. Next question is, which company has achieved the milestone by shipping two autonomous electric barges for Norway based Esco Maritime AS? So here guys, Cochin Shipyard Limited is the right answer. So this organization is a defense company, defense manufacturer based in Cochin. Now what has happened? Let's discuss that and let's not delve into the words, let's understand the concept. So Cochin Shipyard Limited has developed two electric barges, and those two electric barges have been exported to the Norway based Esco company. Okay, I hope this much is clear. Now here is the peculiarity. First is that it was for the first time that Cochin Shipyard Limited has developed the barges and exported it. Okay, and secondly, this Esco Maritime AS is basically, this company is aiming to become zero emission company. So these electronic barges are going to help this company in becoming a zero emission company. Now what exactly a barge is? That should be your question. So let me show you. Guys, this is a barge. Okay, what is the purpose? The purpose of it is to supply or transport basically cargo. Okay, in the canal. Okay, you can see the space or the design of these barges is very thin. Okay, the width is very less so that it can pass through canals easily. So that's the basic idea of the barges, which Cochin Shipyard Limited has developed. And remember, these are electric barges. Okay. Now, this ESCO project, I have already told you, it's an ambitious project of Norway, and the basic purpose is to contribute towards green shipping program. I hope that all of you know what green shipping program is. Green shipping program is to use electric or renewable resources run ships and cargo transportation on the ship routes, okay, on the sea routes basically, so that the emission of petroleum or diesel can be reduced in the oceans. That is the basic idea of green shipping corridors that India is also aiming to develop. And how many green shipping corridors will India develop? This is your next question. Do tell me in the comment section below. I know that I have asked you many questions by now, but these questions, guys, are your homework. If you do them diligently, I guess this will help you in memorizing the past facts as well. Okay, we have done this thing in the past. Okay, how many green shipping corridors will India develop? Okay, so this Esco Maritime company is the largest supermarket chain in Norway. Okay, so zahir hai ki iska saman ship se idhar transport hota hi hoga. So in order to make it emission free, these electric barges are going to help this company. Okay, moving ahead, which of the following country is not the partner country in the G7 summit 2022? So G7 summit was hosted by Germany recently, and there India was also invited as a partner country. So Mr. Modi has visited Germany to attend the G7 summit. So out of these countries, which one is not a partner country? So the right answer is Brazil. So guys, before moving into the details, let me show you the G7 countries: Canada, US, UK, France, Germany, Italy, Japan. Now how can you memorize these seven countries? Canada, US, the mammoth, okay, as far as you consider the area. So the pair of two countries, Canada and US. Then we have UK and France, which are known to be arch rivals. I hope that you know a bit about their history, that they used to be arch rivals of each other. So UK, France is one grouping. Then we have Germany, Italy and Japan. All the three countries, or we can say the dictators which were responsible for the World War II. So you can remember these three countries, the pair of these three countries in this manner. They are the basic cause of World War II. However, it is not that these countries were the only one responsible for the World War II. I'm just saying it so that you can remember the G7 better. Okay, Russia used to be a part of it, but it was kicked out in 2014. after the Crimean annexation. Okay, so I hope that now you can remember the G7 easily. Now let's understand what has happened in the G7 summit 2022. So first of all, it was held at this location, Schloss Almu, okay, in Germany. Then Germany holds the presidency of G7, obviously that is why it is holding the summit. The theme of the G7 is progress towards an equitable world. So do remember the theme of G7. Then guys, G7 chancellor has invited India, Argentina, Indonesia and Senegal and South Africa. These countries were invited as partner countries, and there were partner organizations as well, like UN, WHO, World Trade Organization, IMF and the World Bank. Okay. The one most important announcement that was made at the G7 was the $600 billion commitment towards global infrastructure project. I hope you all know that the G7 had announced in the previous summit also that they are going to cater or tackle the Belt and Road Initiative of China. Okay, and for that, in the last year summit, they had announced 40 trillion worth of an initiative. Now they have announced that they are going to give $600 billion for helping the countries, developing countries, in developing their infrastructure so that they can be prevented or protected against China's debt trap and Belt and Road Initiative. Now, from this $600 billion, US is going to contribute $200 billion and rest of the countries are going to give the remaining amount, okay? And remember, this amount is to be contributed by 2027. This is another fact of importance. Now, here you can see G7. Earlier it was G8, Russia was kicked out, and now there are talks that Russia should be kicked out from the G20 as well. But as you can see in the newspaper or in the environment generally, that now there is no such talks, because right now the world is focusing on including Ukraine, Moldova and Georgia into the European Union. So that is what going on right now. It is not being talked about to kick out Russia from G20. Okay, this year G20 is being hosted by Indonesia and next year India is going to host it. Now, where will India host this G20 summit? In which state or union territory? This is your next question. Tell me in the comment section below. Even though you don't know the answer, it's good. It's fine, because it's the very recent current affair. If you don't know it, I will tell you. Okay, but just try to attempt this question in the comments. I hope that the question is clear. G7 summit is clear to you all. Okay, so the next question is, which country will get the Iskander M missile system from Russia? So guys, it is a nuclear missile, and Russia has promised, do listen to me carefully, Russia has promised to give this missile to Belarus. Okay, Belarus is one country which is right now being looked with suspicion for helping Russia in the invasion of Ukraine. Okay, so continuing that only, Russia has announced that Russia will give this nuclear system, missile system, to Belarus. So that's the basic news. Okay, now these are some of the specifications of the missile system, which obviously you need not to memorize. Again, don't memorize these specifications. This is just to show you how lethal this missile is. Okay, moving ahead, this is guys the missile and these are the leaders. We all know this man, but do you know this man? If you know, then tell me the answer. It is, but basically he is the Belarusian head. He's the present head of Belarus. Tell me the name of this person. Moving ahead, what is Mumbai's rank in the Global Livability Index 2022? So here guys, Mumbai's rank is 117th. Economist Intelligence Unit has released this Global Livability Index, which assesses 140 cities. Now Vienna, the capital of Austria, is the first in the list, and from India, New Delhi is at the top rank, and the global ranking of New Delhi is 112. For Mumbai, it is 117th, okay? So guys, this is the list of the cities which have topped the list of Global Livability Index, which you can see. Vienna, Copenhagen, Zurich, Calgary from Canada, Vancouver, Geneva, Frankfurt, Toronto, Amsterdam, Osaka, Melbourne. Now, don't try to remember the top 10. You can just remember the top 2, Vienna and Copenhagen, okay? Moving ahead, which bank has launched Campus Power, the one-stop digital platform for students? So here, guys, ICICI Bank is the right answer. So the Campus Power is basically a facility, a suite of services that ICICI Bank has launched for the students, so that those students who are looking for loan, the students who are looking for opening an opening a saving account in a foreign branch or in a foreign bank, they can get all these services under one platform, okay? So on this platform, all these financial services will be provided by ICICI Bank to the students and their parents in general for their children's education, including the education loan, okay? So that's the basic idea. Khayal Aapka is the tagline of ICICI Bank. The next question is, how much loan has Gujarat Outcomes for Accelerated Learning received from the World Bank in total? Okay, so here the right answer is 500 million. So guys, understand this thing, that $500 million is the total sum, is the total loan World Bank has announced to give to Gujarat for this particular project. Out of this amount, now Gujarat has received $250 million from the World Bank. Okay, so this much is the received amount and this much is the total amount. Okay. Now, not only Gujarat, many projects have received funding from the World Bank. So first is this Gujarat Outcomes for Accelerated Learning, which is abbreviated as GOAL, and the total amount is this. Purpose of GOAL is to improve the learning outcomes at the school level. Then we have, okay, I have already told you that $500 million is the total commitment World Bank has given to Gujarat for this particular project, and this amount was approved in 2021 itself. Now we have the fisheries sector. So this loan has been given to the Government of India for improving the fisheries sector in India. So total $150 million has been given. The purpose is to boost the fisheries ecosystem. Next is Tamil Nadu's rights project. So the loan amount is $162 million, and the purpose of this project is to strengthen the social protection system in the state, okay? Be it in the form of social inclusion, be it in the form of increasing the accessibility or opportunities for the persons with disabilities. Last but not the least, Uttarakhand, which has received the loan worth 1,000 crores. Now understand that here this 1,000 is in Indian currency, 1,000 crores, and earlier the amounts which we talked about were in US dollars, okay? So this 1,000 crore has been given to Uttarakhand for promoting the rain-fed farming and agricultural and making agriculture climate friendly, okay? So these were the loans that World Bank has given to India, to different states of India. And I hope that you all know this fact, that whenever an agreement is signed with an international organization, the Government of India automatically becomes a participant of that agreement. Okay, so every agreement that the state signs with IMF, World Bank, ADB, AIIB, or any multilateral agency, it is a trilateral agreement involving the Union Government of India as well. Okay, so that was an additional information. Now, you all know that World Bank is a group of 5 organizations, and these 2 primarily comprise of the World Bank's functioning. This is something that is very basic. All of you must know this fact. Can any one of you tell me that out of these 5 organs, India is not a member of only one organization out of these 5? Which one is it? This is your next question. And guys, this is very basic and static. So I expect all of you to know the answer and tell me in the comment section below. The 9th question is, again, a very important question. who has been appointed as the CEO of Niti Aayog. So after a long period of time, now the Niti Aayog has got a new CEO, and that is Parameshwaran Iyer. Now do remember his prior occupation. He was the former drinking water and sanitation secretary, and he is known for spearheading the Swachh Bharat mission, basically for leading in the Swachh Bharat mission. Like we say that Nandan Nilekani is the architect of Aadhaar, similarly he is the person who has contributed significantly towards the Swachh Bharat mission. So that was his prior occupation. Now he is the CEO of Niti Aayog, and this is the man we are talking about, okay, Parameshwaran Iyer. The last question is, who has been appointed as the CEO of India Debt Resolution Company? So right now new CEO has been appointed, and the person is Avinash Kulkarni. Okay, so let's know something about this India Debt Resolution Company. I hope that all of you know the bad bank, National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited. So this IDRCL is a part of it. This is going to acquire the bad loans from the banks, and this is going to resolve them, basically realize the bad assets. It is going to actually sell those bad assets, okay, of the banks that NARCL would acquire. So that is all, and the target right now is to realize 83,000 crore worth of NPAs of the banks in India. Now do remember that IDRCL is a private sector company, because 51% of its share holding is owned by the private banks. So this is a very significant statement, guys. Do remember this statement. And the 7-member board of this organization is headed by SBI's executive Divakar Gupta. Again, both of these statements are very crucial, so do remember. So here, guys, this is the man, Avinash Kulkarni, and here the session ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the session. I know that the session had too many questions to ask. I have asked too many questions from you, but I expect my sincere students to answer those questions. Even if you don't know, try to attempt those questions. Try to find out from the Google, so that when you do that, you try to memorize it for a longer period of time. So on that note, I'm going to end this session.